Yeah, the continuation of electric displacement vector. At last, we have stopped up to P is equal to E epsilon naught plus P. So this D is called, we are saying that displacement vector. And we can write that equation, last equation, D n cap is equal to sigma, right? So last what we have written, E into epsilon naught plus P into n cap is equal to sigma. From that equation, we are writing D n cap is equal to sigma. So you know down, this sigma is directly proportional to D, but not E. So this is a major difference when introducing a dielectric. So we will have electric displacement vector here. Therefore, what we can conclude here in the sense, polarization P, electric displacement vector, and applied electric field all are in parallel. Okay, so polarization and dielectric displacement vector and electric field all are in the parallel. Right. And afterwards, what we are going to do in the sense, we are going to take the ratio between D as well as the ratio between E, we are going to calculate. So what is D from this equation? D is, we have written as sigma, right? So as we know that E is equal to sigma by epsilon naught, instead of sigma, we can write sigma minus sigma P by epsilon naught. And this equation, this denominator of denominator should goes to numerator. So sigma into epsilon naught, sigma minus sigma P. And this term, somewhere else we have studied, what is this? D by E is equal to K into epsilon naught. What is this K? It is called dielectric constant. Yes. So from that equation, afterwards we can write D is equal to K E into epsilon naught. So the electric displacement vector in terms of dielectric constant, we can write D is equal to K E epsilon naught. And so here we find the value of D in terms of dielectric constant, and we can use the this equation, right? So epsilon naught E plus P is equal to T. This equation we know, right? So E epsilon naught plus P is equal to D. From that equation, what you can write, P is equal to D minus epsilon naught into E, right? So what is P? P, what is D we found? K into E into E epsilon naught minus epsilon naught E. Okay, here we have the same parameter. So I can take a con as constant, E epsilon naught as constant. I can write K minus 1. And from that equation, I can write, sorry, I can use this side, right? Okay. So P by E is equal to, I can write epsilon naught K minus 1. So P by E is equal to K minus 1 into epsilon naught. And what is this P by E? That P by E is called susceptibility. Chi E is equal to epsilon naught K minus 1. This is called, we can say, electric susceptibility. This is one of the characteristics of the given dielectric, electric susceptibility. Chi is equal to epsilon naught into K minus 1. And we can write this P, we can write, that we can write XC is equal to epsilon naught K minus 1, right? So what we can going to come S. Instead of this one, instead of P is equal to E epsilon naught K minus 1, we can use P E, instead of epsilon naught K minus 1, we can use chi E, right? Therefore, we can define P by E is equal to electric accessibility chi E. Or otherwise, we can define polarization P is equal to the product of electric field and electric accessibility.